Hello friends, today we will see a priori algorithm example. You can see example on the screen. We have given transaction table and we have to generate candidate item sets and frequent item sets from this table. We have to apply a priori algorithm on this table. The minimum support count given is 2. You can see our transaction table contains two columns. First column is ID and second column is list of items. There are total 9 transactions T1, T2 till T9. Each transaction contains certain elements or list of items. For example, transaction T1 contains P item, Q item and T item. Transaction T2 contains Q item and S item and so on. Now first we will scan our data set. Scanning means we thoroughly read our data set and we will find out individual items present in our data set. We can see we have 5 individual elements P, Q, R, S and T in our data set. The first step is we have to generate one item set frequent pattern. For generating one item set frequent pattern, first we will scan our database D, which we have done previously, and find out we have 5 individual items. One item set means our item set contains exactly one element. We will represent candidate item set by C1. It will contain 2 columns, item set and support count. Item set contains individual items, which are P, Q, R, S and T. Now we will find out support count of each and every individual item. P has support count 6. How it is calculated? For that, we have checked our transaction table. Item P occurs at transaction T1, T4, T5, T7, T8 and T9. Total 6 times it is present in our transaction table. Therefore, support count of P is 6. Similarly, we will find out Q has support count 7, R has support count 6, S has support count 2 and T has support count 2. Now, by using this C1, we will find out L1. L1 means frequent list 1. The item sets which satisfy the minimum support count condition will be added to the list L1. If we can see C1, if the support count of each and every element is greater than or equal to 2, then and only then we will add a particular element to L1. Here you can see all the elements from C1 had support count greater than or equal to 2. Hence, all the elements are moved to list L1 as it is, because all the items satisfy the condition. The next step is we have to generate 2 item set frequent pattern. 2 item set means item set that contains exactly 2 elements. We will generate C2 candidates from the frequent list 1, that is list L1. We will make L1 join L1 and make pairs of each element. You can see the item sets present in C2 as P with Q, P with R, P with S, P with T, Q with R, Q with S, Q with T, R with S, R with T, S with T. Here you can notice I have skipped the pair QP because in set theory both sets, if set PQ and set QP, both sets are same. The order doesn't matter. Hence, I have skipped the pair QP. Now, again we have to find out support count of all these item sets. Now, for item set PQ, support count is 4. How it is calculated? Again, we have to check our data set. PQ item set is present at 4 positions: transaction T1, transaction T4, transaction T8 and transaction T9. Hence, the support count of pair PQ is 4. Similarly, we will find out the support count of all other pairs. Now, with the help of C2, we will generate frequent item set list 2, that is L2. Our condition says if item set's support count is greater than or equal to minimum support count, then and only then it will be added to L2. Now you can see here support count of item set PS, item set RS, item set RT and item set ST are less than 2. Hence, these item sets are rejected. They are not included in list L2. L2 will contain only the elements PQ, PR, PT, QR, QS and QT. Because the support count of these item sets is greater than or equal to 2. Till now, we have not used a priori property. What a priori property says? Any subset of frequent item sets are also frequent item sets. For generating 3 item sets, we will make use of a priori property. 3 item set means item sets that contain exactly 3 elements. For creating 3 item sets, we will make use of L2. L2 join L2. For example, we have first 2 pairs PQ, second is PR. We will make pair as PQR. Second, we can combine PQ with PT, PQT. Similarly, we got all the 7 pairs PQR, PQT, PQS, PRT, QRS, QRT, QST. Now, according to a priori property, we have to check all the subset of these item sets. I will explain first subset. Our first item set is PQR. The subsets of PQR are PQ, QR, PR, PQ and R. Now we will check whether these subsets are frequent item sets or not. For that purpose, we will check our list L2 and L1. In L2, you can see PQ, PR, PT both are present. And also in L1, PQR, all the 3 are present. Hence, all the subset of list PQR are also frequent item sets. Hence, this pair is selected. Again, for pair PQT, all its subsets are also frequent item sets. Hence, this pair is also selected. Next, PQS. For the pair PQS, the subset PS is not frequent item set, because you can see the support count of PS is 1. Hence, we have rejected that pair. We have not included PS in the list L2. It means PS is not frequent item set. Hence, PQS pair is rejected. Similarly, all other pairs have one subset which is not frequent item set. Hence, all those pairs are also rejected. After applying a priori property, in C3, we get only 2 pairs, PQR and PQT. After find out these item sets, now we have to check the support count of these pairs. For that purpose, again we will check our data set. For PQR, the transaction T8 and T9 contains PQR, so support count is 2. And transaction T1 and transaction T8 contains PQT item set. Hence, the support count of PQT is also 2. Therefore, C3 contains PQR and PQT with support count 2. Again, for creating list L3, we will check whether the item sets present in C3 satisfy our minimum support count criteria. That is, they should have the support count greater than or equal to 2. As you see, both the pairs have support count 2. Hence, both the pairs are listed in the frequent list 3, that is L3. Now we will generate 4 item set frequent pattern. 4 item set means item set that contains exactly 4 elements. For generating 4 item set, we will make use of L3. L3 join L3. So you can see PQR, PQT, PQ is common, hence the pair becomes PQRT. Now we will check all the subset of this pair or this item set PQRT. Here you can see the pair or item set QRT and item set RT is not frequent item sets because they are not present in the list L1, L2 or L3. Hence, this item set, this 4 item set PQRT is rejected. Thus, C4, that is candidate item set list 4, is now null. That is, C4 is equal to 5. Therefore, algorithm stops here and we have find out all the frequent item sets and candidate item sets by using Apriori algorithm. Thank you. If you like my video, please press like button and subscribe my channel. Thank you.